Hey, good morning there, everybody. Happy Friday to you. Give me a fist bump. Blow it up. Hey, I know you've seen my dog Wrigley in the past couple of videos. Well, Wrigley finally got his quarantine cut. He was just looking like a mop, and now he's looking like a pretty handsome dog. Check this out. Hey, Wrigley. Yeah, he's looking pretty good, but he looks like a stranger to me. So Wrigley got his cut. So again, happy Friday to everybody. Last couple of days, we've been looking at the Cold War. And by the way, it is not cold today. It is a beautiful day out here, mild temperature. Get your work done, get outside, enjoy it. But we've been talking about the Cold War. And what you've got coming up today is a proxy war. It's one of the first wars during the Cold War. It's called the Korean War. It is not the United States and Soviet Union embattling with each other directly. It's a proxy war where they're supporting different sides of the war. So you've got the Korean War. You'll also see the space race, which is the race to get up there to outer space and show the dominance on Earth and also in the outer space between the US and the Soviet Union. And you've also got the arms race, which is the race between both countries to build up their nuclear weapons. And they had this thing called mutually assured destruction. And their goal was that if one of them fired a weapon, the other would fire back, and they would continue firing until they assured that both had been destroyed. So that's what the arms race is all about. I want to give you a couple of quick book recommendations real quick here too. First one is Suspect Red by L.M. Elliott. This is about spies and espionage during the Cold War. It's a really cool book. It is historical fiction. This one is also historical fiction. It is called A Night Divided by Jennifer Nielsen. And this is about the Berlin Wall and about a family that had the Berlin Wall built while their father was away, and the wall literally split up their family. And one more, this one is not historical fiction. This is a true story, Most Dangerous. It is the story of Daniel Ellsberg and the secret history of the Vietnam War. That's a really cool, really cool book as well. So I know it's hard to get a hold of books right now, but just in case you got a list going on and you want to start jotting it down, or maybe you got an Audible account or something like that. So I wanted to give you a couple quick book recommendations. So I hope that you have a good day. Hope that you have a great weekend. We do not have school on Monday. No school on Monday. You've got a 3-day weekend coming up. I will not post an assignment, neither will your other teachers. So just know that you got time here to catch up and make a good push to the end of the school year. We've only got 2 weeks left. You got this, everybody. You got it. Give me one more fist bump. Boom. Hey, one last thing. Washington, D.C. I'm going next June 2021. If you're interested, I've sent emails. I've posted on Classroom. Check it out. Talk to your parents about it. It's an awesome trip. I hope that you come with me. See ya.